Hi guys, welcome. This will be our first studio vlog. Yeah, we thought you might be interested in what's going on at our place, what we're working on, what we're using, new gear we have, and also like kind of what videos will be coming in the future or what is planned. So yeah, just like an update. Yeah, for example, we've been quite busy the last couple of weeks or months, so we ordered some new gear for our studio. So for example, we got the Antelope Zen Studio for a new ADDA conversion slash interface thing, which really is great and a big improvement in dynamic range sort of things. Yes, so maybe you'll get a review or just like our experience with the difference between the Antelope and our Focusrites for you. And we also ordered some Clark Technic compressors and EQs. So we already got the KT2A, which is the LA2A clone, for the unbelievable price of €299, which is amazing for a full tube compressor. We also ordered two 1176 clones from Clark Technic and two what's it called? The Pultec EQ clones. Yeah, I think it's EQP, EQKT or something like that. Yeah, but they're not here yet. They will be coming here somewhere around March, I think. And yeah, we'll try them out. We have to repatch the studio, get a patch bay, and all that wiring stuff to make that really work. But yeah, you can expect to see a review of those things, and also maybe a little bit about how we changed the studio setup and the workflow so we can actually properly use them for tracking and also mixing. Yeah, we got some nice amps coming up for Sound Sick. I got a very nice vintage Fender Bandmaster from around 62-ish, so a brown face Bandmaster. We also have the Petersburg P100, which will be great for all you stoner and doom and you wanna know the heavy rock and roll guys out there. So you'll be seeing that one. And we also, what was that? What was the other thing we had? Yeah, we got a Tysco, the Tysco 10. It's like this miniature combo thing made in Japan, full tube, so even a tube rectifier. So that's gonna be coming up soon. Still got a hum in there, which I don't quite know how to get rid of that because I changed all the caps and everything in this amp because everybody said, like, you know, the Japanese caps from that era were just crap, so just throw them out. I measured them afterwards and they were mostly really all crap. But I still got some hum, which is coming from the output transformer, I think, but I'm not quite sure what it is yet because I hope it's not the output transformer itself, because then I'd have to buy a new one for a couple of it's not $100, but it'll be like 50, $60, which is about what I paid for the amp. So yeah, yeah. No, but we had something else. Oh yeah, we filmed the mic shootout, so you'll be seeing another mic shootout come up, and then probably next couple of days actually. We have a clean, a crunch, and a high gain mic shootout for guitars, all looped with drums, whole mix, and also soloed again. I think we have like 24 different mics. We just basically put everything that we had in the studio in front of a cab and yeah, went for it. So yeah, I think that will be quite interesting to see for your studio and gear heads. Yeah, and I think that's basically it for today, I say. If you're interested in anything, if you have any questions about Sound Sick stuff or any amps or any guitars or, I don't know, the studio or our work or anything, just let us know. We'll be happy to answer them in the next vlog. And yeah, I guess that's it. So, see you soon. If you like this video or if you like our channel in general, if you're interested in old amps and weird stuff, all the quirky things that make sound from all times. Just subscribe. Yeah, just subscribe. You'll be happy about it. And we'll be happy too, and you get notified for every video that we post. Yeah, so have a good one, and we'll see each other soon again, I hope. Goodbye.